Hello students, today we are going to study about 10th standard chemistry, the next chapter after ammonia in study of compounds is nitric acid. We are going to learn a very important topic from this chapter today about the preparation of nitric acid in an industry. The industrial preparation of nitric acid is what we are going to study. The industrial preparation of nitric acid is known by the name Ostwald process. This process is carried out in big industries and factories for the manufacture of nitric acid in large quantity. Let us understand the important steps which are involved in this process, which is called as Ostwald's process. The Ostwald process is the name given to the industrial method of preparation of nitric acid. We are going to see the different reactants which are there for the preparation of nitric acid in the industry. The reactants which we require are ammonia and air mixture. The air which contains oxygen and the other components as well are taken together and are passed into the catalytic chamber, which contains a much higher ratio of air. You need to learn, students, the amount of ammonia and air, what is the ratio for them? The ratio is 1:10. It shows that the air is required in a large quantity. So there must be a reason behind it. Why such a large quantity of air is required? Here comes the reason. Air is used in all the three main chemical reactions that is there for the Ostwald's process. So in all the three main chemical reactions, which will take place in catalytic chamber, oxidation chamber and absorption tower, will require oxygen. And for that reason, air has to be taken in a large quantity. Let us move on to study about the reactions which are there for Ostwald's process. I will talk about the reactions as well as the chambers which are involved in this process. Let us move on with the first step, step number one, which is done in the chamber named as catalytic chamber. You all can see, students, here in this diagram, we can see that there is a platinum gauze which has been kept inside this apparatus or the arrangement which we say. In this first chamber, ammonia and oxygen from the air is allowed to go inside. Let us see the other important thing that is going to happen here. The conversion that takes place in this catalytic oxidation, that is, ammonia is getting converted to nitric oxide. Ammonia NH3 reacts with the oxygen in the presence of the catalyst called as platinum, which is written as PT, at a temperature of 700 to 800 degrees Celsius, and the products formed are NO, water, and a large amount of energy is liberated. The NO is nitric oxide. This is to be used further in the process, and that is why you can see, students, here it is written NO is coming out of this catalytic chamber. Now, since we have written a chemical reaction, let us talk about the balancing of the chemical reaction here. It is a very important chemical reaction, students, for which you can remember the balancing as 45 and 46. So 4 times ammonia reacts with 5 times of oxygen in the presence of the catalyst platinum at a temperature of 700 to 800 degrees Celsius, giving out the products as 4 times NO, that is nitric oxide, and 6 times water vapor, and a large amount of energy as well. So we all can understand that it is an exothermic reaction. Since it is an exothermic reaction, the heat evolved further maintains the required temperature of the reaction. So the heat is going to help the reaction to go ahead without much supply of the energy from outside. We need to remember the catalyst and the temperature, which are the important conditions for step number one. So in step number one, we are taking NO, that is nitric oxide. This nitric oxide is taken to the second chamber, which we learn as step number two, which is called as the oxidation chamber. The oxidation chamber, as the name tells us, oxidation is going to take place. The oxidation will take place for nitric oxide, which we have formed in step number one. In step number one, we have made NO. It undergoes oxidation process and then it gets converted to NO2, that is nitrogen dioxide. So in step number two, in the oxidation chamber, oxidation of nitric oxide to nitrogen dioxide is taking place. Let us balance the chemical equation. NO is to be balanced by writing that 2, and then we write 2 in front of NO2, balancing the oxygen. We can see it is now a balanced chemical equation. Now, pay attention, students, that here we are requiring a temperature which is very, very less. Only 50 degrees Celsius is what is required. And this is a very important give reason for it. Low temperature is used since they facilitate easy oxidation of nitric oxide to nitrogen dioxide. Another important point here is, if the temperature is high, then decomposition of nitrogen dioxide may take place, which we don't want. So the second point we learn is, it minimizes the chances of any decomposition of nitrogen dioxide, which may take place at higher temperature. So this is the second step chemical reaction for Ostwald process. Now from here, we are going to take nitrogen dioxide gas, which is a reddish brown color gas, and we move to the step number three. Step number three is an important step, students, because here we are going to learn about a very important process, which is called as absorption. And this is named as absorption chamber or absorption tower. Let us have a look at this absorption tower, students. We can see that in this absorption tower, there is some important thing written as quartz. We will see what is this quartz. Let us have a look at the diagram. You can see that water is being sprinkled from the top of this chamber, and at the bottom of the chamber, liquid nitric acid is being formed. And in between are the slabs or the pieces of quartz which have been arranged. Now let us see what is going to happen in this absorption tower or the absorption chamber. The nitrogen dioxide, which we have obtained from step number two, is going to get converted to nitric acid. And that will get converted to nitric acid by the absorption in water in the presence of excess air. Look at the chemical reaction. The nitrogen dioxide gas is coming from step number two. Water is falling from the top. Oxygen is taken in excess, and then nitric acid is being formed. Let us balance the chemical reaction before we go ahead. So that's the balancing. 4 times nitrogen dioxide plus 2 times water plus oxygen gives 4 times nitric acid. Now let us talk more about the quartz. The quartz is packed in layers since it slows down the movement of the gaseous nitrogen dioxide entering from below and initiates better solvation of nitrogen dioxide in water. So what it means to say is, students, see here, this is the inlet from where nitrogen dioxide is allowed to come in, and it slowly moves in the upward direction, and then it is reaching to the top from where water is falling down, and solvation means it starts dissolving in it. So we want slow rate of dissolution, and then the liquid nitric acid is formed. An important reason here that you learn is, why are we preferring to use only quartz material? Quartz is a material which is acid resistant. So we can use this material as vapors of nitric acid, or nitric acid itself is a highly corrosive acid. So we want some material which is not going to get affected. So this is what you learn, students, for the three important steps there which are involved as Ostwald process. So this was all about the Ostwald process, preparation of nitric acid in the industry. Thank you.